I think it's an incredibly exciting time to be a scientist and an engineer. The field of nanoscience, chemical engineering, chemistry, physics, they've evolved to give us incredible tools that we didn't have available even 10 or 20 years ago. We can now control things at the atomic scale. We can measure things at the atomic scale. We can see with different techniques that we've actually made these complicated structures that we think we're making. We'd like to be able to have more sustainable forms of energy. We'd like to have sustainable fuels. We'd like to have faster and cheaper electronic devices so that we could have them embedded in everything around us. My lab specializes in surfaces and interfaces of materials. So we're interested in taking some solid material and modifying it, adding some new property to it with control at the atomic level. The chemistry that we're working on in my laboratory right now is to take carbon monoxide and hydrogen, which is also a very small molecule. So they each have two atoms, very simple small molecules, combine them together, and out comes, if you have the right catalyst, something that you can stick in your gasoline tank as fuel. So what a catalyst is something that speeds up a chemical reaction. Something like 80% of all industrial processes use some sort of catalyst, so it's very important to everything we see around us and materials. One thing that we know about catalysts is they also involve materials at a very small scale. The only activity of them occurs just at the outermost surface of the catalyst. If you imagine the Grand Canyon, right? And let's say you now want to cover the entire Grand Canyon, the entire canyon and the rim of it with an inch thick of snow. The same inch thick everywhere across this entire canyon. If you shrink that down to the types of things we're doing, at that scale, we need to have that inch thick everywhere precisely, and we have methods now that can do that. One of the methods that my group uses a lot is called atomic layer deposition. So it's exactly what it sounds like. We put down layers one atom thick at a time, effectively. And if you keep repeating those cycles over and over again, you're actually building up this material of interest one atomic layer at a time. I love solving problems. Maybe it's the engineer in me, but so much of this research is about solving problems, being creative about designing an experiment or coming up with a strategy because you want to get to some certain endpoint or you don't understand something. That is forever fascinating for me, and I think that drives a lot of my students as well.